Hi guys, welcome back to Tidal Gardens. When it comes to reproductive methods, corals have a diverse skill set. They're capable of sexual reproduction, as well as a variety of asexual methods, such as longitudinal fission seen in corals like Calastria, budding as seen in corals like frog spawn, or petal laceration as seen in some mushrooms, and lastly, especially fragmentation, which makes companies like Tidal Gardens possible. There is, however, a much less common method, which is the subject of this video, polyp bailout. Okay, let's roll that intro. Before we delve deeper into this topic, please take a quick moment to subscribe to this channel if you are into informational videos on corals and reef aquariums in general. Subscribing helps this community grow, and it's a good way to stay notified whenever we upload new content. Polyp bailout is a stress response to unfavorable tank conditions that certain stony corals can activate as a last-ditch effort to save themselves. You may have seen corals express stress reactions in other forms. For example, regulating zooxanthellae can be seen whether it's like browning out to increase the population or bleaching, which is essentially expelling zooxanthellae. Some corals prefer low light, and as a stress response to too much light, might form oxide radicals in their bodies that resemble like bounce mushroom bubbles. It's part of the reason that the first time that I saw a bounce mushroom, the first thing that I thought of was that it's just a regular Rhodactis with horrible tumors. Anyway, those are just some examples of stress reactions that are fairly common. Polyp bailout is a much more extreme measure, which I liken to a fighter pilot hitting the ejection seat and hoping for the best. During polyp bailout, polyps are killing off their own connective tissue through apoptosis. For those that are unfamiliar with the term, apoptosis is programmed cell death, as opposed to, say, necrosis, which is traumatic cell death. Apoptosis is a highly regulated and controlled process, so the coral polyps bailing out due to stress are doing so in a direct, calculated response to an exogenous threat. It is certainly not a common occurrence, but over the years I've seen it happen in SPS like Pocillopora and Stylophora, as well as in LPS such as Euphilia and Catalophilia. The SPS corals seem to do this much more successfully, but perhaps that's just a numbers game. A colony of Pocillopora or Stylophora might expel 100 polyps during a polyp bailout event, where only a small fraction survive and regrow onto a more favorable substrate. This is in contrast to a large polyp stony coral like an elegans, where it's just a single polyp with a sliver of a chance of survival after bailing out. When things go right, however, it's an unexpected surprise. We tend to see SPS colonies pop up seemingly out of nowhere on the side glass of the aquarium or on an overflow box. Although much less common, here's a head of frog spawn that detached in horrific fashion to regrow on the bottom of the tank. This little head has survived now for over 6 weeks, so I think it's well on its way to recovery. So what causes a coral to decide to bail out? That's not quite so clear, but there are a number of possibilities. First off, is any shift in temperature. In a home aquarium, temperatures are relatively stable as compared to my greenhouse, for example. But when something goes wrong in a home aquarium, temperature-wise, the effect is way more severe. Small water volumes can either heat up or cool down very quickly, and that could cause this type of stress response in corals. Similarly, sharp changes in salinity could be the cause. Again, it's not typical for a home aquarium to go crazy salinity-wise, but it could happen, especially when the testing device has not been calibrated in a while, and the readings might have actually drifted significantly. I've seen a refractometer be off by a whole 0.005, so a reading of 1.025 was actually 1.030. On top of that, there were plenty of times where that tank was giving readings of 1.028 or 29, meaning the specific gravity of that tank may have drifted upwards of 1.035, which is clearly too high. Having said that, the animals in the aquarium may have a muted stress response to that salinity because that sort of change happens gradually. But the moment you get that new coral, that poor little sucker is going to be in a world of stress. Even if you took an insanely long time to acclimate it, there's a really big difference between acclimating a coral for, say, an hour and slowly changing salinity over a few months. So that could be a stress-inducing event that could activate polyp bailout. Okay, three. There could be a chemical change in the aquarium, which could either be too little nutrient, too much nutrient. I've seen one scientific journal describe polyp bailout happening to a specimen with low food availability, and I've personally seen it happen in systems with an overabundance of nutrient, and that's kind of signified by high nitrate. Lastly, I could see coral bailout due to some manner of pest infestation or harassment from a fellow tank inhabitant like a fish or an invert. Okay, that does it for this short overview of polyp bailout. I hope you never have to experience it happen in your aquarium, but it's something to be aware of nonetheless. This hobby isn't always puppy dogs and rainbows, and occasionally our tanks let us know when we're being an unfit coral parent. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, happy reefing.